Hi, thanks for joining me today. I'm going to show you how to make this cute little treat holder, and I learned how to make this last week at the Stampin' Up! Leadership Conference. Pam Morgan showed us how to make this, and I couldn't wait to get home to make a bunch of them. So I'm going to show you those really fast. Here's the one, I think I kind of made this one first because I overlapped it a little too much. But there's a little incentive stamp in there. Then I'm going to move this out of the way and bring you this other bowl, because then I decided to change it up just a tad and put the little scallop here and just insert some little candy. This one is a little different. There we go. Okay, like I said, I came home and made a whole bunch of them, but the one I'm going to show you how to make today is this one. This is the one that my club girls are making this month. And we're going to use the Love You Much stamp set, since it's very close to Valentine's. To make this project, you're just going to need the regular scallop circle die that goes with the Big Shot. So it's not the number 2, it's just the regular scallop circle. And all you need to do is put just a strip of sticky strip about right here. I made enough of these now that I think some people might put it on the side, but I just put it a little here to the right in the bottom. Okay, and then you just kind of overlap it. And after making a bunch of them, I decided that I liked the opening to be a little bit wider. If you look at this one, you'll see how I overlapped this more and the opening's kind of small. So learn from my mistake that you would like the opening to be a little wider. That way you can fit more in there too. Okay, so that part's pretty much done. See how easy that is? But now we're going to decorate it. So I'm going to take the Love You Much, the little hugs and kisses. I'm going to ink this up. I'm going to take the, 1¼ punch and punch this out. And the reason I'm punching this out first instead of covering that hearting is I want to give that a chance to dry. So while I'm waiting, I'm also going to punch out a 1⅜ Riding Hood Red piece. And then the scallop circle is going to be chocolate. Maybe I should put this back over here so you guys can be looking at it while I'm making it. Okay, I'm going to get the Riding Hood Red ink with my aqua painter. It's a little too wet. Okay. I'm done with that. Now what did I do? I'm going to put a dimensional right there. And in a minute, I'm going to put crystal effects on here. Then attach this. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? But that's okay. I can do this now. I'm going to go ahead and... Ooh, I put that on crooked. I'm going to set this on here and pierce the scallops. I like that look. Okay, now I've gone ahead and cheated and put the 3 Hershey Kisses inside the small cellophane bag, and I used our linen thread to tie it closed, okay? Sometimes it's kind of hard to hold the bag closed and tie this, so what I did was I tied it twice. So I kept the linen thread long enough that it would go around twice. Okay, and so some people will say, well, how'd you get the thread through there? So what I'm going to do is put this back on here, find out kind of where I want to position it, and then I'm going to make that hole a little bit larger. Okay? And then thread this up from the bottom. Well, I'm going to try. I probably should trim it with my scissors. Watch this not work. No, it's going to work. I didn't say that. See? It worked. here. Now I'm going to go ahead and apply some crystal effects to make the little heart shiny. Is it coming out? Okay. It's clogged, so I'm going to take a needle. There we go. Since it's clear, I was having a hard time seeing it. Okay. You get the drift. I think I could add a little bit more. Make sure you don't touch that when you do it. Okay, so I'm going to take the Riding Hood red striped ribbon, and I'm going to use a glue dot to attach it. You know what? I'm actually going to clean up the edges first, because I don't want to cut my cellophane bag. Okay, glue dot. And then you just kind of tuck the bottom in, and then just stick it in there. And then you can make your own crinkle paper using the tabletop trimmer. So there you have it. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks.